Everybody, welcome back to 4. Now, where we last left off, we ran through the subway, and we're trying to escape the fire guy, the fire demon, whatever his name is. What? We're going ever so deep into his lair. Find out what's going on, and if you look up here, somebody's watching us.
So during a certain point of the night, I could listen to the wind, but it was not like a regular wind. It was a really strong presence, and I could feel that it was the force of the wind combining and meeting the force of the water. This spirit of the water, it's called Iemanjá. And the spirit of the wind is called Iansan. So when they meet, you could feel the presence in yourself.
Yeah, this is all about spirits. And if you guys want me to do a review of this game, when I finish it, let me know.
But where does it start? That's where our brain is. That's where our thoughts are processed. What is it? Is it just a room for all of these ideas? Is it a holding space? Is it even truly ours? Are we just floating through here and floating through other places at the same time that we're just not aware of? What we hold on to, what we see the most, is what we've decided to believe. Your consciousness could be anything and nothing all at once. Anything is possible. It's just how much you're open to and willing to believe.
Interesting. World. lots of symbolism here. A lot of symbolism. Dude's on drugs. He on drugs. He's on that fucking cocaine. Okay. caused all this? That's what I want to know. Things had to have been people at one point. At least the ways to avoid them are clear. Like, it's kind of set where you need to go. But it's literally just because my character is so slow that makes it all the more stressful.
What's going on here? You just gotta find Dana, man. She can figure this out.
The mirror world? Is that what we're
in? You should go. I'll go too. Okay?
The mirror world? Is that what I'm in?
Thank you.
His eyes are glowing just a bit. Oh, that means he can see me. Has to be a mirror world then. It has to be. Time to run. This is either a dream or the mirror world. This has to be a dream or something. It just has to be. Nope, I know what that means. Thank you. Run, run, Ian, run, run. Fantastic. I just thought maybe all those burning bodies could be the time my character died as well.
Are you sure? Have you thought this through? You want to put everything back together, but it doesn't come without the pain. I thought I was over you, but I have to admit, it was great seeing you after so long. Maybe I was wrong about us. I don't know. It's a big decision. Come see me when you've made up your mind.
Where's this the apocalypse? That's what I'm wondering. Judging by everything, the way things have been laid out here, it looks like they've been here for a long time. Very. Very long time. Get there. Why is that of importance?
When I came back, this was all I found. A dead planet with nothing left of you but ashes. So I went away, and I tried to forget you.
So I was right, these are my characters.
But then, I thought, maybe I did want to see you again, so I created a place for you to come back to. This place. I'm sorry, I couldn't remember every detail of how it was. It's just been so long.
This dude's hell, his heaven.
Now it's up to you. You need to decide whether there's a way forward.
Interesting. Very interesting so far.
Pretty soon, you're gonna have to choose whether he lives or he dies. Whether everyone lives or everyone stays dead.
Sorry to put this burden on you.
Oh, she's a lot bigger. Oh.
Oh, you made it. I knew you could. Buddy, I talked to Dana. I hate to tell you this, but she says this is it for you, pal. You're on the wrong side of the mirror. You and this place, you're gonna go away. But as for where I go, that's all up to you. Take my hand, and I get a second chance. All of us get a second chance. That hammer? That's the other choice. But you don't need to use that, because I've changed. I've learned so much from you. That bully in the sewers, you did the right thing. I see that now. And at the theater. You did everything you could, and all the other things you did in the city. I get it. I understand who I need to be. It's your call, buddy. And we're asking you to pull us out. It's what you're here for.
Why not?
Thank you, buddy. I can't thank you enough.
Oh.
Just like I remember. I can't wait to get started.
Thank you.
game. So, it literally is the mirror world theory. For those of you that don't know, the mirror world theory is that there's an opposite being of us on the other side of the mirror. And when we look into a mirror like I am doing right now, they're doing exactly what we are doing, except there's something major about them that is different. Our good side and our bad side, that's what this whole that whole theory is about. But I'm curious to see that other ending where I hit them where I used the hammer. Where I hit the hammer and everyone dies. Because in this, my character pretty much just saved the world. But here comes the review part of the game. I enjoyed it. As you could tell by the end, it was obviously meant for VR, meant to be where you could peek around the corner. The game was a bit too dark, but not in a scary sense, but in an environment to where I had to turn up gamma in order for you guys to see. But other than that, the game has, it's one of those, what's the right word? To where you can, you gotta look deeper into this type of game. I was right in the end about the theater. You guys saw I was there for a good 10 minutes doing all that I could. And I later looked on, there was literally no end to it. It would have just kept going and going and going until I got tired of helping everybody. But it shows now that the, those burning bodies were my character, his evil side. That giant creature was in fact my character. So my little theory about that was correct. But the question is the bad ending. This is obviously the good ending. Everybody gets a second chance. What about the bad ending? That's what I want to know. But I did. I don't know how long these credits go, if there's anything at the end. So I'm just giving my thoughts on it. But I will upload the bad ending tomorrow. And that is when the final ending of this will be out. So I do thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I did. It was a little spooky, but the lack of enemy variety was, I mean, at the beginning, when you meet the quote-unquote Wendigos, it was like, okay, it's scary, you're confined, and you're in the darkness. But once you get over the fact about them that they're easy to avoid, it becomes a cakewalk. I wish they would have done more with the enemies in the golden masks. It's almost like those were guardians meant to keep everybody in line. I hope you guys enjoyed.